Now you will understand the meaning of resource, definition of resource or concept of resource. Students, now I am going to discuss the different types of resources. Resources can be classified on different bases. On different bases, it means there are different bases on which resources can be classified. First one is on the basis of origin. Second one is on the basis of adjustability. Third one is on the basis of policy. And fourth one is on the basis of status of development. One by one, I will clear you every different types. This one is on the basis of origin. Resources are divided into two types, biotic and abiotic. On the basis of origin, resources are divided into two types. First one is biotic and second one is abiotic. And if you see the term, you will find out bio word is connected to this, in this word. That bio means living things, or as you know, in the subject of biology, we study about the living things. So this can imply that those resources which we obtain from living things are called biotic resources. It means livestock, crops, fruits, those things all are included in the biotic resources. Abiotic resources, those resources which are obtained from non-living things are called abiotic resources. Abiotic resources include fossil fuels, minerals, minerals resources, energy resources, etc. And second one is adjustability. On the basis of adjustability, what is meaning of adjustability? Adjustability means which can adjust or not. Just like those substances on the basis of adjustability, resources are divided into two types. First one is renewable, and second one is non-renewable. Again, if you see the term technically, you will find that in this term, two words, this term is made up of two words, re and newer. Re means again, newer means we get again new. It means these resources can be renewed again and again. This type of resources include, it means those resources which can be renewed in a fixed period of time, those time period which are suitable for human beings. It means 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, this time period can be, not millions of years. Again, or 100, 200, 2000 years. It means renewable energy resources include solar energy, wind energy, water energy, forest. These resources are considered as renewable resources. Non-renewable resources, those resources which we cannot renew in a fixed time frame. That is those, the time frame or time period is suitable for human needs. Minerals, fossil fuels are example of such resources. Minerals and fossil fuels. Mineral and fossil fuels are example of non-renewable resources. Again, now, on the basis of ownership, resources are classified into four types: individual resources, community-owned resources, national resources, and international resources. Now, I will define all the four types of resources on the basis of ownership one by one. Students, on the basis of ownership, the resources are divided into four types. First one is individual. Second one is community owned. Third one is national, and fourth one is international. This shows that those resources which are owned by a people or a group of people or group of individuals. It means like agriculture land, on wells, etc. present in our country. Those are owned by in one individual or group of some individual. These are for individual resources. Students, we have given agriculture land on the payment of taxes to the government. That is why these are individual resources. Community owned resources, those resources which can be used by all the members of the community. It means if my resource, this is community owned resource include like grassland, burial ground, etc. It means that burial ground can be used by all the members of that community. If some other member want to use that burial ground, in this case, those members have to obtain permission from that community or representative of the community. Students, I want to again clear this. If a grazing ground is present in a village, then that grazing ground will be used by only the members of that village. It means that grazing ground is the property of that village or that community. I hope these 2 points become clear now. Now the international resource. Sorry, now the national resource. Students, you have to attentively listen to these points because it may create some confusion in your mind. Students, national resource, whatever pertains in a country within national boundary of the country, all resources are considered a national resource. I want to repeat this point again. Everything pertaining within the national boundary of a country is a national resource. It means whatever pertaining in a nation is a national resource. But minerals found anywhere in the country is the natural resource. And other resources like land may be obtained from the farmer or people for the good of whole community or for whole country. You have heard many times that land are acquired by government for the purpose of construction of roads, bridges, or some township. That is why everything pertaining within the national boundary of the country is considered as national property. Students, so we say that technically all the resources belong to the nation. Country has legal power to acquire even private property for the public good. You might have seen fields owned by some individuals are acquired by the government for the development of township, like you may say Greater Noida near the Noida. Because our capital region, Delhi NCR, is expanding day by day, so fulfill the needs of township. A large area is acquired by the UP government for the development of Greater Noida. Students, one more thing I want to clear here. All the minerals, water resources, forest, wildlife, land within the political boundaries and oceanic area up to 12 nautical miles from the coast each nationally, from the coast in national resources. Students, here I want to clear one point. What is territorial water? What is territorial water? In case of India, if you will see the map of India, this is the Arab Sea and this is Bay of Bengal. No sea present here, and here national boundary is this. It means the west coast and east coast of India. But according to the international law, from the coast of any country, 12 nautical miles, it means this area, 12 nautical miles, it means this area is also considered as the mainland of the country. It means a government